Oh, God.
Yeah. That's what I thought of when you're like, I got to take care of my cat.
Well, I mean, he's climbing up my shirt right now. Why don't you just start it?
Well, that's a hell of a visual.
That was a nice cold open.
Hello and welcome to the Ritual Misery Podcast, episode 125 for Thursday, the 27th of April, 2017. This is the show where two lifelong friends and their guests celebrate all things geek. The problem is that I'm Kent and I'm without Amos. However, that's A-okay because we are about to find out if it is indeed that time of the month. We have Krunchy and Jackie Hearn with us, both returning guests. We're always glad to have them here. And you guys used to do a show together called That Time of the Month.
Yeah.
And this is sort of a like a reunion show of sorts, I think.
In a way.
Sort of, kind of.
Kind of, sort of, should have, if you would have. Yeah, no. I mean, I don't know, Krunchy. I think I don't know if I speak for both of us that we just so much work.
Yeah, believe me, I absolutely get it. So the chat
it's
is
a lot more work for you than it was for me.
I'll no, give it. Oh, don't say that. Oh, now the truth comes out. Only here on the RMP podcast or the
So the chat is wanting to know where is Amos. He decided, you know what? We got too many guests.
He decided, Jackie's there. She's going to talk too much. I won't get into word in edgewise.
In that case, I think I might bow out and just, this can just be an episode of, That Time of the Month. Oh. No, I'm absolutely thrilled to have you guys on here. Amos has some family stuff going on. We might hear from him later in the show. So we'll find out, if that actually happens. But it's RMP. It's Thursday night. I'm so glad to be here. This has been a weird week for me. Okay. So I know I talk about how I'm always busy at work and things are just, you know, chaotic. Man, all that kind of came to a head today. I work in a place where I can't have my cell phone inside the building with me. It's one of those type of places. Yeah, so I went outside. It was like just after lunch, I think. I went outside to check my phone, and I had a missed call. Okay. Who's this missed call from? It was somebody that was not in my contacts, but it was a local number. In fact, the prefix even was the same as my prefix. But I was like, I don't recognize this number. What is this? So it's just kind of a personal thing or whatever. If I don't know the number, I don't call it back. But I got curious, so I Googled the phone number, and a name came up. It was like kind of like a reverse lookup, like caller ID type of website, and a name came up. I didn't recognize the name, so I was like, huh, let me follow this rabbit hole. So I copied the name, Googled the name, and the person that called me from an Alamogordo number, that name came up in Google as a convicted murderer that killed someone outside of Alamogordo a few years ago. Turns out that there is an A&E TV series that covered this guy's murder.
Don't call that number back.
I'm not calling that number back.
What was the thing, murder thing? Because I probably caught it.
You know what, you might have. I'm gonna put this up. I'm gonna put this up here. The show is called The Killer Speaks. It was a season two episode. It was the third episode of season two. It features an interview with this guy, the guy whose phone number called me today. And it kind of freaked me out. Like, I went back inside. I talked to some of my coworkers about it. I was like, I think I just got a phone call from a convicted murderer. Now,
season one, episode two?
No, season two, episode three. Okay. Yeah, kind of freaked me out, and everybody was like, don't call that. Don't call that number. I was like, okay.
Two things.
All right. Totally not gonna.
Whoa. Two things. You have the same name as this guy?
No, no.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
This is Timothy.
The name.
I will say the
less. Well, the last name.
That's said a thing. So.
So.
But the other thing that even through all this, and this is an interesting story, but the thing I can't get over is that you called an area code a prefix, and I thought that was funny.
Well, no, it had it. No kidding, it had the same area code and prefix. Had both. The same first six numbers were all the same as mine.
Hmm.
So it was definitely a local number, and yeah, and this is the only name that came up in.
Dude.
Yeah. Now, my only consolation here is that the guy is still in prison. He got convicted in 2013, I think, and he's serving a life sentence. So, I'm thinking it's not this guy.
Or he tried to make a call from jail, and he couldn't completely remember the number he was trying to call.
Oh God. Yeah, I don't know, but it freaked me the hell out. Krunchy, tell me that you had a better Thursday than I did.
No, I mean, I got a gym membership while simultaneously getting really fat. That's about all I've done this week. So,
Jackie, your Thursday must have been better than mine.
Oh, it must have been, because you know what? It was my It was Jackie Hearn's birthday.
Today?
420.
No, 420.
Oh, 420. That's right.
420 was Jackie Hearn's birthday. And you know what? I got so many lovely, just messages on Twitter. Maybe on Facebook. I don't know. I don't look at Facebook. And it was so nice and so sweet of all these people. I was in the goddamn hospital.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
What were you donating blood or...
I was donating all kinds of organs. Organs people don't want anymore.
Oh.
It was really nice, very special. And, when you turn 20,
Like you turned this year?
Yeah, right.
I'm so jealous of all you guys for aging backwards. I remember when all of you, I think last time I was on the show, all of you were turning 29, and even that was like...
Oh, God, I remember 29. 29 sucked. It's so much better.
I don't remember 29. That was a while ago.
I remember it, but now I'm honestly, I'm like 26, so,
Right.
Yeah, you're right. It does go backwards. I had some shit I had to do, and... it's okay. It's nothing serious or whatever, but could have been serious if I couldn't get to the hospital. And, so that kind of sucked because, 420 is a very special day for me. Mm. And, I kind of want to ask Krunchy what she did for that because she's got some notes there, but I ended up spending my time that week playing, The Sims on my iPhone. And what I love about The Sims, I used to play The Sims way back in the day, but I used to wall Sims in and make them die of malnourishment and just suffer and die in different off rooms.
I used to put my Sim in a swimming pool and then take the ladder away.
You can't do that anymore. Or you can't do that with the new iOS game. And it took me a week to figure that out. And so now I'm really pissed off. But on top of that, I watched a whole shit ton of TV because there's way too many shows. The Handmaiden Tale, which is amazing. I read the book way back in the day. But The Feud, Betty and Joan, that's fucking amazing too. And, of course... You know, Better Call Saul, of course, as anybody would know me, Fargo and all that stuff. But Mystery Science Theater 3000, too, which I saw somebody else had a comment on that, too. But yes. But yeah, birthday stuff, you know, that's that.
So to talk about MST3K, like I was so excited that. That this is back, and I was giving
you multiple segues there.
I watched the first one, and they covered the movie Reptilicus, and holy crap, oh my god! So I'm somebody that I really love kaiju movies. So bring on all the Godzillas and King Kongs and Pacific Rim, all of that stuff. I love all that stuff. Gamera, all those sorts of things. And this movie, Reptilicus, is very much one of those, except it's really bad. But MST3K covered it, like, super well, and...
I don't remember the first one. You gotta remind me of what happened, because I remember the first one being excellent. Yeah. But what...
Right, so the plot of the movie, they were drilling in Norway, I think it was, and they came across this, like... I guess it was a tail segment, and then there was, because he brought the drill up and there was blood all over it. So then they, so this tail turns into this giant monster, and it's so bad.
And I felt really bad because, like, I remember at some point while I was watching it, it was during the Diamond Club movie party.
Ah, yes.
And I was way into it, and I couldn't get out of bed. I couldn't fucking get out of bed and get into chat room. But you guys were watching... What the hell were you watching? It was like sausage party, greasy sausage party.
Oh, the Greasy Strangler. Last week we watched the Greasy Strangler. And oh my god.
Okay.
You want to talk about a bad movie? Like, this is something that MST3K would... not even touch with a 10-foot pole. There's no way. Chat, if you were at this movie party, just go ahead and throw some lines from the movie into the chat so that our audience can enjoy that. That's did you catch some of it, Jackie?
I caught like a few minutes and I was like, I'm going to pass out. And I was trying to get to my keyboard to say hi, but I was just like, I can't. And I just, like, you know, because that was the worst time of, like, how I was feeling.
Oh, I gotcha.
So, you know. But, yeah, I did sign in, and I saw that, and then I, you know. But it, like, you guys, like, there was this, like, weird dude. And then, like, all these naked, ugly people. And then I was like, I can't. And then I would pass out, and I would look back at my monitor, and you guys were still, like, looking at, like, naked, like, people that were just...
Krunchy,
dripping.
Krunchy, do you watch bad movies on purpose?
I hate movies, but here's the thing. It's going to shock everyone. I watched a lot of movies this week on 420.
Oh my gosh.
They were doing, like, a whole bunch of movies on Comedy Central. So I watched Harold and Kumar, the first one, the good one.
Fun fact,
the last full price movies that I watched in theater was the second Harold and Kumar, and me and the lady actually walked out. That was the last one I paid for.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
But actually, 420 came on, and we watched Harold and Kumar, and then we watched Dude, Where's My Car? And then, has anyone ever heard of the time-traveling Bong?
No.
Apparently it was a TV series, but it only had 3 episodes, so they just combined it into a movie. But it was the weirdest shit I have ever seen. Like, it said it was TV-14, which it turns out that's only because it was blurred and there's no version where everything's not blurred. But that, it had everything. There was, like, incest and racism and Michael Jackson molesting little kids. And there was, like, a full frontal of some guy peeing on everyone. The movie ends with a conclusion of a guy saved the world by jacking off onto a computer.
multiple
people jacking off the entire movie. Like,
jeez, like, what the hell? And it was only TV-14.
Yeah, because it's blurred and there is no unblurred version. But I suggest, if you're ever bored, go, there was an orgy. Go to gomovies.to and just look up Time Traveling Bong, because you can watch literally anything on Go Movies and you don't have to download it, so it's not pirating. Just do it.
Holy crap. Oh my gosh. So Poodle Puncher, if you're watching, or actually the DC Movie Party producer is actually in chat, Sasien.
Yes.
Take note. That's a contender. Oh my gosh. So Jackie, do you like to cook?
No, I don't. Yes. No, actually, I mean, I like to cook because it's cheaper than going out.
Yeah.
And depending on where you're living, it could be very expensive. But I listed this as my most geekiest thing I did this week, because I don't know if cooking is a geeky thing, but to me, it has become a geeky thing.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to share this with everyone in the world. But on PBS, if you've got PBS in your location, you know, it depends on certain networks. There's a show called America's Test Kitchen. Sometimes it's called Country's Cook or something, depending on what hour it's on. But it's the same group of people, and they have, I will shit you not, they have the best instructions on how to cook fucking food. And they have a school that you can sign up for with a 14-day free trial. And so I signed up for it, and I did this before 420, but yet now I know everything about herbs.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
I know fucking everything. Like when to cut cilantro, like how to cut it.
Cilantro is disgusting.
Yeah.
You don't cut it. That's the thing. You get rid of it. You throw it out.
No. Well, cilantro you have to cut at the very last second, and if you wait too long, it becomes soapy, and that's why people are like, "Oh, I hate cilantro," because somebody cuts it way too early and puts it in. And like that, the difference between fresh herbs and you know and dry herbs, you know how you know you do two to one, basically one tablespoon of fresh herbs equals two tablespoons of dry herbs, or maybe I have that the other way around. I can't quite remember. Anyways, but it's amazing. I've learned so much, and I highly recommend anybody who wants to get into cooking anything, check out America's Test Kitchen on PBS, public broadcasting system. So, you know, you're not going to like, they're not out there to like win any awards or do anything crazy. And, there's so many great recipes. So like I fucking learned how to fucking cook. Finally, after 20 years of my life, I learned how to cook.
You know what? I thought I would try to figure out how to cook, because my mom never cooked. And then I was like always.
Yeah.
I was working 80 hours a week, and I had college at night classes after that. So I never.
That was a thing for me too. I was like a feminist. I was like, I'm not going to fucking learn how to cook.
I just never had time, but I figured I would try to learn. So I signed up for the Home Chef, like one of those things where they send you instructions how to cook stuff and all the individual ingredients. And I got something. It was like, it was basically a sandwich.
It's like a blue apron?
What?
I'm sorry. Go ahead. Okay.
There's a lot more to it than that. But then I was like looking at the instructions, and it's like, okay, now pickle your vegetables. And I'm like, oh, no, I don't want to use that. And then they're like, okay, so spread mayonnaise on the bun. I'm like, oh, no, I'm not going to do that. Mayonnaise is for smelly people. And then they were like, okay, so add the cilantro. And I'm like, oh, I'm not going to do that. So I essentially seared tofu. That was me learning how to cook. So,
well, yeah. I mean, it takes a little bit of a bit by bit, but anyways,
all that shit's disgusting.
If anybody wants to cook fucking anything, like the next thing I'm going to do is pizza dough. If anybody wants to fucking learn any of it, I highly recommend americastestkitchen.com.
Right on. And I'll throw a link in the show notes for that as well.
Yeah.
Very, very cool. I'm pretty good at making grilled cheese. Does that count for anything?
Yeah. Oh my God. They tell you how to make the best grilled cheese with brie cheese, a little bit of mustard, a Dijon mustard, and it's fucking amazing. Like it's just America's Test Kitchen.com.
Yeah. So if you're not studying cooking like Jackie is, what might you be studying, Krunchy?
I broke my back and I am.
It was about the geekiest things we did this week, and I'm honestly padding this little doc because I did nothing geeky at all. So I put studying anatomy, and you all think that's going to be a sex joke, but it's not. I got the gym membership, and so I had like a trainer teaching me how to like do strength training and stuff. And guys, okay, I'm weak, and I'll admit it. Are you supposed to stretch before lifting, or is that only cardio?
Oh, no, you must.
Should always stretch, yeah. You should warm up, okay, and then stretch, and then do the exercise.
That's good, because I fucked it up. it's to the point where, like, my arm doesn't, like, extend all the way. Like, it can, but it hurts, and it doesn't want to. And I fucked everything up. But I lifted.
Well, good.
And that was the thing, yeah.
That's awesome. I need to start doing that again. Ever since I got out of the military, I said, fuck working out, and I haven't done it.
Oh, I love working out.
Yeah, I need to get a treadmill or something.
I also really like drinking and eating, so right. It doesn't help a yeah. lot, but I like doing it.
Krunchy, you bring up a good point. Are you doing that because of kind of the endorphins it releases that, like, you know, I know that. I get that. Like, myself, I will definitely go run and, you know, push it to the end, like, and I've got Eye of the Tiger in my mind, if not in my earbuds. Like, I mean, is that kind of a thing for you too? That it just definitely,
yeah, it's a lot of things. I mean, it does help anxiety and depression and all that, but like also, yeah. I have a problem with sitting around doing nothing. So if I sit around on the computer all day, I start to feel like a worthless piece of shit. So yes. If I go out and like do 3 or 4 hours of cardio, which is usually how long I spend at the gym, so then I feel better about myself. If I would lose weight, I would feel even better. So I prefer that to doing nothing. It just doesn't bode well with me. Hmm. So, yeah.
Cool. Yeah. Right on. Yeah. Hey, you guys know who Gloria Young is, right?
Oh, yeah.
And I know that when I recommended, you know, that you guys get her on the show, and you did Amos's balls, and then you got her on the show.
Yeah. So what we did?
I get the game here. Go ahead. I'm sorry, Kent. Go ahead.
No, I was gonna say. So what we did? We reached out to Gloria.
You got her on the show,
as suggested. Yes, and we did a recording on a weekend. It obviously was not part of the regular RMP show.
No, it's Patreons. We know
it
very
is
well.
Right now, it is exclusive to our patrons. So if you would be interested in hearing stories about Justin Robert Young, if you're interested in hearing stories about Justin as a kid, if you're interested in hearing stories about how Gloria grew up, stories about her family, all kinds of just amazing things. If you want to hear an hour-long conversation.
I'm surprised you didn't get her Ted Bundy stories.
Well, that we'll save that for part two. If you're interested in hearing all of Gloria's wonderful stories, and believe me, it was really good, go over to patreon.com/ritualmisery. Give a fuck, give a buck, and we'll give you everything that we can, to include the pre-show and post-show of our episodes. You get a lot of extra things like the Gloria Young interview. Just whatever we can dig up. There's some things in there, some embarrassing things from Amos's and my past from like 20 years ago.
Oh, nice.
There's all kinds of stuff in there. So check it out, patreon.com/ritualmisery.
Whoa, Gloria, Gloria. I think I got your number.
Gloria.
Gloria.
Oh, jeez.
I think I got your alias. That you've been living under.
Oh,
guys,
my.
Do you really remember?
Yes, Krunchy.
There is a thing that I wanted to say just because it's slightly geeky in that it's my next cosplay, but it's actually really just dumb. and it also has to do with the 420 in the movies. I just received my bubble wrap jumpsuit in the mail because it's part of the costume for Dude, Where's My Car? Because that's one of the only movies I can actually quote constantly. And I reference a movie and nobody knows what I'm talking about. But I got the Zoltan, like, costume in the mail the other day.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
Holy crap. So there's going to be pics, right?
Of course.
Awesome.
I mean, it'll probably be at Dragon Con, so there'll be tons. But I'm going to have to, like, size it. Because I know it's going to be too long for me because I'm a fucking midget. So I'm going to have to, like, try it on and cut it before that. So, yeah, sure.
That is awesome. So, hey, ladies, I've got one question for you. Are you ready?
No.
Yes.
For Ted?
You've got 60 seconds. Get your mind right. It's time for Hot Takes on the Ritual Misery Podcast.
All right, so normally...
That's hard to deal with when I hear Jay's voice, because it's so amazing.
He's so great, isn't he?
He's amazing. Oh, man,
we absolutely love Jay around here. So normally the way this works is that I have one guest to ask questions to. I have two guests. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask the question, and then you two both answer. Whether you're talking over each other or you talk to each other and take turns, it's completely up to you.
You know that I'm going to talk over Krunchy.
And so that's Krunchy... fine, because I am really bad at talking on command.
So the only rule is when you hear the record scratch, you stop talking and then we move to the next topic.
Mm-hmm.
So here we go. All right, ladies. Tattoos, am I right?
Ding.
I like tattoos because tattoos are good. I want to get a rooster tattooed on the back of my kneecap.
Commercials for feminine hygiene products. Am I right?
Oof. Stop.
I don't do that. So.
Puppet shows. Am I right?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you need something? I can get you some ice cream if you would like.
Flowers and rainbows and sunshine, am I right?
And hot dogs. You forgot the hot dogs.
Okay.
That's what I know is like the general like other thing that sunshine and hot dogs. I've heard that one, I think.
And as always, the Ritual Misery Podcast. Am I right?
That's so great.
So great. I don't remember if I've written a shitty 5-star review or not for that show because, I mean, I have a lot of shit I could say about it.
Oh, man. That was awkward and amazing. And Krunchy brings up a good point. Everybody should go to iTunes and give us a 5-star review. But give us the shittiest review you can possibly give. Say like, man, that hot take segment is garbage. It's a piece of crap.
Sluts. You know that?
but give a 5-star review and we'll read it on the show. Make it funny. Make it awful.
Give them a goddamn great review because it's a goddamn great show. Like, honestly, like I've been going back. Well, I'll save it for later. But I've been going back listening to a lot of your old episodes, and you guys got a good thing, and you should be proud of it.
So well, thank you. Yeah,
you're welcome.
Yeah, I mean, man, do you believe we're going on
Boom.
3 years?
Put my foot down. That's fine. That's...
What?
I don't know. I heard my toilet flush.
That's amazing. Okay. So that was a total technical mistake on my part. Okay. So tell me again how great the show is, Jackie.
It's great.
That's I appreciate that. We're going on 3 years now of doing this show, and
wow,
we went from
hey, Ethan Kane's in chat. You see that?
Oh, hey.
Oh, hey, fucko.
Get in here for the game. We'll save it.
Yeah, so...
The show sucks. You're right. Damn straight it does.
So he might be calling in later. Hopefully okay. he does, but it apparently is not going to happen just yet. But yeah, so we'll see what happens. So have you guys seen this Amazon gadget that has just been announced called the Look, the Echo Look?
No.
This thing, man, okay, so you know what the Echo Dot is, right?
So, right.
Yeah, so the thing that you can basically just talk to, it's kind of like a Siri in a can, basically, that you know you can tell it to do things, you know, whatever. So they decided that we're going to take this one step further. We're going to make one for the purpose of it is to put it in the bedroom. And it has a camera on it.
Right. Okay. No. I had to make sure I knew what I was talking about because I put something in the dock and I didn't know. Yep. Go.
So this thing. Okay. So the whole idea is that you put this thing in the bedroom and that you can, try on outfits and tell it to take a picture of you so that you can look at yourself. It's kind of like a new next generation mirror kind of thing, like so you can
right.
see yourself
it
from all
uses
different
the
angles.
Brown shoes do not go with black pants. God damn it.
Yeah, so that's the intention, but it can also take video,
right?
And you could talk to it. You tell it, hey, trigger word. I'm not going to say it on the show, but hey, trigger word. Start the video or record video or whatever the command mm-hmm. is. Tell me that this thing is not going to be used primarily for recording porn.
As soon as you said you put it in the bedroom, that's the only thing I could think of. Especially, and then you said video. Like,
yes.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
And they're marketing it for use in the bedroom. Like,
you know what? Sex sells. So it's not a bad plan.
Right.
I mean, honestly, in this day and age, like, oh, I'm sorry. Aww. See, my cat has everything to, you know, how much are you going to trust devices when you go over to somebody else's place and think there's no way that there's not a device recording anything?
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Back in the day, you could go over to somebody's place and think, it's going to be fine. But, like, like my cat says, no.
Yeah, exactly.
I didn't even think about that. Going to somebody else's place would be...
Yes!
I don't know if I can trust anyone ever again.
Yeah.
No, I know, you can't.
Like, it's a fairly common thing to be at someone's house, and like, let's say they're having a pool party or something like that, and you're like, hey, do you mind if I go change in your bedroom? I mean, that's a fairly common occurrence, right? Yeah. So... Like, man, maybe you
not
don't want to do
that
anymore.
Man. Like, can I just give you a blowjob in your bedroom? And, like, make it, like, I mean, because sometimes blowjobs are, like, very independent. Like, it's very, secretive. It's between you and me. No one else in the world ever needs to know. You know, I mean, if we need to go out to, like, the car or into a stairwell or something... Like, I'll give you a blowjob and nobody will ever fucking know that it happened. But now they will.
So, with that in mind, is anybody else going to Nerdtacular here in a couple months?
What?
Nope.
Oh, anyway. Sorry, bad joke.
Are you going to put it in your car? Is that your bedroom?
Right. Yeah. No, I was trying to riff on the tangent that Jackie took that down because we were talking about a camera and then all of a sudden we're talking about blowjobs and cars. So
I'm not driving a Nerdtacular.
Yeah, hell no. I'm not driving.
I'll fly there. I mean, that's...
exactly. Yeah.
I mean, at least fly into Sacramento. I used to live there. I don't know.
Sacramento is quite a ways from Salt Lake City.
I mean, through. Oh, that's true. I guess international. I haven't looked up the international flights, but
right on.
I guess Salt Lake from Burbank. I guess you could do Salt Lake from Burbank. That's true. I fly from Salt Lake to Burbank quite a lot.
So, but, Jackie, what is this? What is this other device? You put a story about a device that Google is coming out with.
Oh, okay. Awkward. We're talking devices. I feel weird now. Okay, so there was a story in The Verge today that anybody can use actually a Google Assistant gadget. Basically, they've set it up so that you can use a you can use the device, and they're gonna try to make it so that you can if you're a developer or programmer, you can take it. I'm trying to open up the story so that I have the actual language here. But as long as you have speakers, if you got a way, you can make your own Google Assistant. And it could be done via your Google Watch. It could be done by your iPhone. As long as you're able to hear and talk to and say, okay, Google. And I thought this was pretty awesome. I thought this was great. Because I don't know. Like, I for the last 5, 6, 7 years, I've been following Google and their Google programming. Like, sites where you can learn to program and code independently, and I think this is another addition to that. And I think it's great. So you'll be able to do that. And see, actually, you broke up my story a little bit, because my story was that I told these kids to stop screaming.
Oh, I got you. Okay, all right. So, yeah, my bad.
No, it's fine. I ruined it. It's all done. But there are these kids that scream bloody, bloody murder right outside my window every single day at the same time. And I caught them the other day, and I went out and I ran out. I ran out, and like, my hair was all like, you know, disheveled. I was like, hey, are you okay? Are you all right? Need help.
Oh my god.
No, I was such a drama queen. And I asked them, do you need help? And they're like, we're okay. We're fine. I'm like, well, I don't know. You're yelling and you need help.
Oh my god.
Should I call 911? I'll call 911 and I'll help you. And they're like, we're fine. Please don't call 911. I'm like, are you sure I called 911?
How old were these kids, Jackie?
They were like 7 or 8 or 5. They were middle school.
Oh my gosh. And, like, these 10-year-old kids.
They were so upset with me. And I was so happy. I was so happy. I was enjoying every minute of my, like, you know, stage production. And then they left, and they're like, we're fine, we're fine, we'll leave. And they left, and then I went back inside, and I was like, everything's great, I did a good job. And then I got inside my apartment, and I was like, oh, I'm such a bitch.
No, it's amazing. I can't wait to be the old man that's like, get off my lawn!
Yeah, I was like, I'm such an asshole bitch for, like, ruining their party. But, I mean, they were screaming. They were screaming bloody murder. And they did this every day, every single fucking day. And I was supposed to do a podcast around that time. And, like, every couple of days, and I had back pain. I had shit I was dealing with. And I thought I should say something. But anyways, yeah, I felt like such an old lady. And I thought, oh, my God, if I could just create my own Google Assistant, take care of it. So that was my segue that you ruined.
I love everybody in the chat room. First of all, somebody's like, what did I walk into? I stepped out for a peanut butter cup, which is the best excuse ever for leaving the show.
Yes.
Okay.
And then Squid says, it started with Amazon, look, spying on a pool party sex.
Well, my whole point is that, you know, I can't wait to create my own Google Assistant that will make sure I don't have to go outside and yell at kids.
You think pool party sex comes with peanut butter cups?
It fucking better.
I don't like soggy food, though. So if the peanut butter cups got in the pool, I probably wouldn't like that very much.
No, that's like the God, what's that movie where they go do-do-do-do?
Is that Hello, Mother?
Oh, do-do-do-do. There's poop in the pool. It's
I'm all that tech.
Caddyshack. Fucking Caddyshack.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Anyways, whatever. Sorry. I'm just so glad I could say Caddyshack before you were like, what are you talking about, doo-doo, Jackie?
Oh, my gosh. Anyways,
all right. So, there you go.
Hey, Krunchy, do you go to church?
I do not.
Now, is that just because you haven't found the right church? Or
I haven't found the right church. There's, you know, we have a sound effect for that. I want organs.
Right.
There's in Denver, Colorado, because, you know, Colorado, people started a Church of Cannabis, which is getting really mixed reviews. But, oh, God, if you could have I have the link, but if you can pull up the link with some of the pictures, it looks awesome and trippy as fuck.
Yeah,
but
I've got the video playing in the feed. So, yeah, so they bought a church, basically, like an actual church. Like, it used to be, I think, like a Methodist church or something like that. And they call themselves, what is it? Elevationist.
So it supplements your own religion with, I guess, a different religion, but... sounds kind of legit.
So what I gathered...
Because it's not just like a pot-smoking party is basically the thing. It's an actual religion.
Yeah, so what I gathered from it is that it doesn't supplant your current religion. Like, you can be a Christian, a Jew, Muslim, Scientologist. I mean, you can be whatever it is that you believe in and come to this church and, I guess, worship with everyone while high. Is kind of the idea. Like, you can go to this church, go upstairs on the balcony or like in one of their little worship rooms or something like that, blaze it up, and maybe talk to God.
Which is, I would imagine, I don't know how I'm not a stoner, honestly, but I mean, that sounds like the best idea for it. Everything is probably better high if being high works for you. It doesn't work for me, but I mean, I would imagine.
Yeah, I mean, this is something I would be interested in visiting that. Now, me as a I'm currently employed by the government, and I am not allowed to partake in such things. But I think if I wasn't, I think I would really enjoy going to this church. If for no other reason than to just to check it out. Just like this has to be a trip. I mean, no pun intended, but it's got to be a trip.
I would totally go to check it out. I mean, I can smoke if I am, like, super, super drunk where I won't remember anything, which makes it kind of pointless. But, I mean, otherwise, it gives me, like, too much anxiety. So
Right. Drinking
gets rid of all anxiety, so you drink, and then it's cool. And then I'm really amused by everything. So.
Right. Yeah. Jackie, would you go to the Church of Cannabis?
Oh, no.
Hi.
Well, okay, so if you wouldn't go to
I don't need to go to somebody's place. I just need to go to my apartment and just light up.
Well, I was going to say, if you're not going to go to church to smoke cannabis, would you maybe reach for a beer instead? Like, maybe a...
I will smoke marijuana with my legal license that I've been provided by the state of California.
God bless them.
To fight depression. And I will fucking smoke that. Yeah, I'll do that.
Right.
I don't know. I mean, yeah, maybe I'll go to your church if you got, I don't know, some fun parties going on, some nice recreational activities.
Ideally. I'm just saying, ideally, if you could mix it with alcohol, like a anti-Trump fake news ale. So then while you bought this ale, it actually donated to causes making all these stupid bullshit laws he's making illegal. And the strange thing is, this is out of Canada, because even all the other countries are laughing at us for this president. But fake news ale with a great picture of Trump on the front.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry. I was focusing on other things and I didn't catch on. But yeah, anything to distract from that.
Yeah, I think, yeah, the funniest thing about this story is, to me anyway, the funniest thing is that it is a Canadian brewery that's doing this. And that's funny. So
what's that all about?
What's this about? Sorry. What's this about? I love our Canadian viewers. Who am I kidding? Nobody from Canada watches us.
Nobody anywhere.
Oh man, yeah, no, but this is pretty cool. I'm a beer guy. I would totally drink this. It sounds like they're giving, what is it, 5% of all sales, which probably equates to about a quarter of their actual profits are going to go to causes. Apparently, like lobbies and things like that, that will be trying to reverse the laws that this president has been enacting.
God bless Canada.
So yeah, that's
just blame Canada.
So,
Jackie, from that South Park thing. Blame Canada.
Oh yeah, I know. Of course. But then again, you have to consider that since then, South Park has said they're going to quit doing political shit because Trump is funnier than
comedy. That was a long time. Yeah.
Real life is better than comedy is basically their thing now.
All right, well, I'm sorry
because of all this fake news.
So I've got one more topic to bring up here, and then we're gonna get a phone call to hear a story. But real quick, so I remember like years ago, decades ago, when I tried marijuana, I got really hungry afterward, and I would have done anything for some McDonald's.
Okay, so let me ask you, I don't know. I don't think it's fair for me to make you clarify, but are you saying that there was one time you tried marijuana?
Exactly one time. Yes, that is correct. Okay.
Okay, so I shouldn't push it further and say...
Yeah, so all I can tell you really is that when I was in high school, I tried marijuana once.
I'm sorry, you're only like 20 years old, so that's... Okay.
Well, that's right. Yeah. So this was just a few years ago, apparently. Oh, man. But Krunchy, you've heard about this, right? Like some people go to extremes to get some McDonald's.
They do, really... And I used to work at McDonald's for a long time. They go to their extremes.
Right. Even if you're 8 years old, you'll do anything to get some McDonald's is what I'm hearing.
Yeah. There was... Well, first of all, there was a lady that always came in that trained her 8-year-old to lie to us so they could get free extra hot fudge on their sundae, and she would save like a quarter. But but apparently people are stepping up their game now with all this new technology. 8-year-olds are going to YouTube to learn how to drive. And YouTube is doing a damn good job, too. Like, this kid apparently followed all the traffic laws, followed all the speed limits, all the stop signs and the stoplights, and he did a damn good job. You know how long it took me to go through drive-thrus before? Like, I drove, but I wouldn't go through drive-thrus because I thought I would hit the wall. And this kid aced the fuck out of it.
Oh, my God. Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Like most of us adults are shitty drivers. We're going to not come to complete stops at stop signs. We're going to jump over curbs, all this kind of crap. And this 8-year-old learned how to drive literally from watching YouTube and was a perfect driver. Like, I think we could all learn something from this kid.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
And he didn't, it wasn't even selfless. He brought his little sister with him to get a cheeseburger because he was a good human being.
What I loved about this story is, that the cops came, obviously, and detained this kid. But they called the grandparents to come get the kids, and they waited, like they let them eat their McDonald's while they waited for grandma and grandpa to come get them. So the trip was not better. The trip was for not or wasn't for not. So all right, we're about to we're getting a phone call here. So Amos, are you there?
Hey fuckos.
Hey, can you guys hear Amos? And Amos, can you hear them?
Barely, but it's okay.
Okay. All right, what you got for us, man?
All right, so listen, okay, I had to get special clearance from the wife to tell the story, but I had to tell the story, and I figured that these two guests tonight would be the perfect people to hear the story.
Okay.
All right. I told everybody last week that my father-in-law was coming. He arrived on Friday, and I'm here to tell you that there is no better aphrodisiac than having your father-in-law in the house, because holy shit, my wife's been rabid like the last week. It's been great.
Okay.
Now, the problem here is that I don't have a conclusive evidence as to him leaving, if that's what cut off the aphrodisiac effect, or if it was just a final satiation, because this is what happened. So the first night that he was here, you know, things went on. You know, we did the sex, and then like every night after that, we did the sex except for one. But other than that first night, I was the only one satisfied.
Okay.
Because I suck at life, apparently.
So you're not good at things, I guess.
Yeah, I'm just not good at things. I'm not good at anything, at all, ever. And then, you know, so I don't know if it was because, well, she didn't get hers, so now she wants to go the next night, or if, you know, whatever the case may be. However, that's supposed to work out, because then the day he leaves, we did it again, and this time she got hooked up and properly handled. So now the entire experiment is wasted, because now we don't know what was cause and effect on that one. It was just like an empty experiment.
So I mean, could it have been the you know, that whole thing like let's not get caught, let's, you know, sneak around, the excitement of being sneaky.
I don't know. It could have been the fact that she was TDY. She was gone for a couple weeks or for a week before that too.
Hmm.
I'm just telling you that if you're hitting a little rough spot, because, you know, everybody hits rough spots, just invite your father-in-law over.
So that's the secret.
Okay. I mean, it's worth a try, isn't it?
I mean, I guess. Yeah. So apparently this is RMP After Dark, according to chat room.
That sounds about right. That's probably.
Where I was like, he was kind of, I don't know, looking in a little too much.
Okay.
Oh, that's not sexy.
No, it was weird. It was weird. And, God, it's so cool.
Wow.
You can't just leave it there.
I'm dying.
Hey Kent,
yeah.
On the FaceTime, do you have the microphone set for your mixer or for your mic?
That's actually what I'm trying to figure out here. It should be for the mixer. Yeah, I'm having a hard time finding the actual preferences for the FaceTime thing. So
it's in the FaceTime menu under preferences.
Right, exactly. Yep, and there is no volume anything in that.
So just go into the system settings.
Right.
This is what I love doing, is troubleshooting live on air.
Yes. This is what most of our pre-shows consist of. but yeah, everything, like all of my settings are pulling from the board. So why FaceTime is having a problem with it, I'm not sure.
No, that's awesome.
So, okay, well, thanks for that story, Amos. We're going to go ahead and let you go because...
How are you going to kick me off my go goddamn show? This is bullshit. What the fuck?
Can you hear me now?
And that was Amos. Awesome. That was an interesting story. I know in my distant past, the presence of a parent.
Can Amos stick around a little bit? Because Krunchy and I have a little game. But
ooh,
does he have to?
Yeah, bounce? he already took off. So
did he take off or did you hang up on him?
Yeah, all right, so
I think it was both. I think they didn't.
I
didn't give a shit, and then
I hung up on him.
We gotta wrap this show. You know, it doesn't really matter who's on.
Yeah, no, I hung up on him, but he had to
just fucking end it.
His kids are doing sports, and so he's at a sports ball thing. So he could only sneak away for a couple of minutes.
He could bounce in for that. He could bounce in for five. You know, that's fine. That's fine.
But yeah, so. Jackie, it's up to you if you want to do the thing or if you want to wait for a different.
That was later on because I don't think we got to that. I don't know. I don't know where.
We've kind of been jumping around.
I didn't know where Amos's balls interrupted this episode. So you have to tell me as the show leader.
Right. Well, you know what? Before we get to any of those other things, I do have one thing that I want to bring up. There's this website that I go to when I want like my geek fix, my little geeky nerdy trinkets and whatnot. And I'm wondering if you guys have heard of this. It's called geekandgamergear.com.
Look, Ethan Kane's still here. Sorry.
He is around in chat room. But so geekandgamergear.com.
He's not here to answer certain questions. Okay, go ahead. But what's this geek stuff you have to talk about, Kent? I'm sorry.
Yeah, so there's this cool ass website called geekandgamergear.com. That's the geek, the letter N, geekandgamergear.com. And I love going there, and they've got the most affordable prices for all of your geek gear. They've got clothing items, they've got little statues, they've got electronics, they've got gaming accessories, they've got all kinds of really cool stuff. I was just wondering, Jackie, have you ever been to this site?
Yes, I have, actually. And you guys are so wonderful and precious to me. You invited me back on to be on the show. And I thought, I'm going to check this out. And I found a wonderful hat. I found... Oh, it's not going to fit. Oh, there it is. Okay. No, is it there? Is it fitting?
It's there.
It's beautiful, right. Jackie. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That is... amazing.
Oh, very large.
But that is a Mario hat that is on your head. And now this looks like it's like real authentic like Super Mario Brothers gear. And that's available on this site. That thing must cost like $50. Probably $50,
no,
right?
No, you know what? It was only $9 and with your offer code, it was 10% off. I got 10% off. Fucking free shipping, okay?
That
okay,
is amazing.
Here's the bonus. Free shipping, so $8.10. I paid for this thing. It's going to be on my head in a couple of days, okay?
That is awesome. And yeah, you used the promo code.
10 days I used the promo code. I'm sorry, go ahead.
I was just going to say, you used the promo code Ritual Misery at checkout to get that 10% off.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I did. I didn't mean to interrupt you. Go ahead.
No, that's what I was going to say. So I'm going to get this hat. And when I ordered it, it said free shipping, free fucking shipping. Okay. Now, it didn't say just free shipping. It said free fucking shipping. I'm kidding.
No, that's amazing.
Free shipping. But it said 2 to 5 weeks free shipping. And I was kind of like, oh, because I kind of hoped I would be able to get it before I was on your show. Where's my hat? Because you can see it on my head. And but then I ordered it the very next day. They shipped it out. So I'm going to get it like tomorrow, but I won't get it today. I didn't get it before the show.
That's so standard. Yeah, I don't get my stuff before the show either.
Shipping. So it was $9 to begin with. So it was $8.10 I had to pay. $8.10. I get this hat, this wonderful hat. I don't know that I'll wear it myself all the time, but I might give it to a friend. It's going to be one of those wonderful little hats and those geek things that I can hey, I'm going to put this on your head. And you're going to think I'm a wonderful person. And, you know what I mean? Like, it's amazing. So,
I love it. That's pretty awesome. Yeah. And you can get that. You can get your own at geekandgamergear.com. Use Ritual Misery at checkout, and you get 10% off your whole order. Very cool. Awesome. I think we might have lost Krunchy.
Oh, no. It took the hat to get rid of.
So, Jackie's not a fan of the hat. Or Krunchy, rather, is not a fan of the hat.
Oh, she is.
So, did you happen to watch the TED Talk?
Yes.
Yes. Do you want to talk about it? We can do that segment real quick.
Shit.
Did you forget what it is?
No. I was making. God, did you not get the reference?
Oh, I got. Okay, gotcha. So here we go. Oh my gosh. So, all right. So this week we watched.
Oh my God, dude, all my homework. I bought a fucking hat. I fucking did my homework, bitch.
So we watched Terry Moore. Why is the X the unknown? So, like in, you know, X Men or X, you know, X marks the spot. X is always the variable. Krunchy, did you happen to watch the TED Talk this week?
I did.
Yeah. So what?
I did stuff.
So what did you think? Do you buy his explanation of why we use X in all of our equations?
I think if it were anybody else, I would have. But a guy talking about how to pronounce things, and that's why it's called X, and the guy has a lisp and can't pronounce things, and also pronounces every word that starts with W, starts it with the letter H. No, I don't buy it.
Jackie, did you have the same take or a different take?
I had a little bit of a different take just because of some of the language studies I've done, that it makes perfectly good sense that, you know, in different languages, it means kind of a different... you know, you like, you're gonna get a different outcome, but yeah, no, I get what Krunchy was saying, and definitely it was I mean, that was my main joke to follow up with Krunchy was saying. It was
yeah. So basically, the origins of this was because algebra is actually from was it Arabic? Is that what it was? I think it was Arabic, right? It was from an Arabic word like algebra. I think it was algebra, right? Which means like the unknown. Like it literally means that in Arabic. And then he does this whole thing where he shows like, you know, how you write the word or the sound that it makes or whatever. And he went into this whole thing, and then when they translated it from Arabic to Greek, they used the whatever the symbol that looks like an X, and then when they translated it then into Spanish, because Spanish doesn't have the SH sound. They don't have a sh sound, which is what Jackie was alluding to. That's why most like Spanish speakers will say things like oh shit instead of oh shit. You know, because in Spanish you don't have that sound. So they translated it to the similar sound or the similar character, I guess, in Greek, which didn't translate to Spanish, and then they translated that into the X symbol in Roman. This whole long explanation in it, but it made perfect sense to me because I like the study of languages as well, Jackie. And it made complete sense. I love tracing the origin of things. Like I usually go backwards instead of like finding the beginning of things. But it made sense to me. Krunchy, you're not buying it though. The guy is full of shit. He's full of is he full of chit or is he full of shit?
He's full of shit.
Amazing. Okay. Yeah, so that was the TED Talk. If you guys want to suggest a TED Talk to us, we would love that. Send your suggestions.
Done one if you didn't already put one in there, and I was like, God damn it, he's got one already plugged.
Yeah, and well, our goal for this segment is to have the audience give us suggestions. So if you want to hit us up on Twitter, at Ritual Misery.
Well, now I become the audience, so I can do that.
Yes, absolutely. So you can hit us up on Twitter at Ritual Misery, or you can email us podcast@ritualmisery.com and just send along your suggestions for TED Talks or anything else about the show for that matter. Jackie, Krunchy, did you guys want to do the segment that you were discussing, or what
are
we doing?
Oh, you are the worst at segues.
I am. I am totally bad. Amos really and I are getting to the point where we can occasionally nail one, but without Amos, I'm just completely...
No, it's good. It's good.
You know what? I think our segues went well enough. They were decent. I'm offended right now.
Krunchy, do you want
to
introduce
it? And that's a credit to you, Krunchy. So
it kind of be on the fly there if you want to just kind of to say what we're gonna do here.
It's we're gonna see how well Kent, and I think Amos is about gone, but we're gonna see how well Kent knows his own show.
Oh God,
it's been his life for apparently 3 years, as you was just saying earlier.
Ooh, okay.
We're taking being a guest to another level, so you guys can't give a shit about being poor guest ever.
Oh God, okay. This is gonna be scary.
Because we did our fucking homework. God damn it.
Okay.
Go ahead, Krunchy. What do you want to do?
Amos, if you're in the chat still, like help me out with this.
Yeah. Well, okay. So, how do we handle this without Amos being around? There's no winner. Not.
Just read shit. We don't need an introduction. We're too good for that shit.
All right.
We got this?
Okay. So, Krunchy, those first two, the trivia questions, that can be bonus. I had them there in case Amos might be around, but I don't think he will be. So.
Okay. And that's fine because you don't have the answer to the first one, so I don't know it. By the way, guys. Jackie says that we had this plan together. She's wrong. I know nothing about this. I'm just making it up as we go.
I love you, Krunchies.
Oh, man. So it's just right like our now, shows. Okay, cool.
There's a trivia part, but we're just going to do who said what, basically. We're going to do quotes that have been said on your show, and you have to tell us who said it.
Oh, dear God. Okay.
Some of them are really easy, so relax. Why don't we make this like just a test run, because Amos is not here and it's just gonna be you, Kent, and we'll see how good you are, because you're gonna fail, and then but we can make it a game we do in the future when Amos can be around.
Awesome. Yep. Okay? I'm down for that. Yes. Right. Yes.
So this is a test run. So Krunchy, why don't you start, and you pick whatever order, and you kind of highlight if you want, and I'll go with whatever, you know, or go in order.
This is a good one to start on. It's about starting. Who said, there's nothing like a podcast starting on time?
Oh, my God. That could have been either one of us.
It could be anybody.
It could be the guest, too. We're going to make it even harder.
Jeez.
It could be anybody. But chances are it was a recent, you know, within the last 100.
God, you know, this is funny because they do a similar thing on Night Attack once in a while. And I'm like, how the hell do these guys not know who said what? It's harder than it. Oh, my
what
God.
Now?
Okay.
What now?
You know what? I'm going to say that Amos said this. I think Amos said it.
Nope.
Oh, crap.
We don't have a you lose sound effect.
Oh, we need a sad trombone.
I totally would have had it if I was on the phone with somebody earlier and I didn't get a chance to.
It was DJM in episode 117.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, and that wasn't that long ago. Oh, man. Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to go here and say, who said, I'll make you say the safe word?
Oh my God. I'll make you say the safe word. Holy crap. I'll make you say the safe word. I'm trying to think of what context that would even be in.
This actually sounds, this is a test run. This is a test run. Like, don't consider this the full game.
All right. I'm going to give my answer and then I'm going to give Amos's answer because he threw something up in the chat. So I was going to say that this was probably from an episode that I had Sassian on.
Yes!
That was that the answer?
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
Look at that. You know your own girlfriend. That's adorable.
Amos in the chat, for the record, thinks Richard Gunther.
You were talking about a Doctor Who. Definitely.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead, Krunchy.
Okay, the next one is, like, there's a method to this show. And I don't know if Jackie would allow this, but I am going to tell you that it was you or Amos. So,
okay.
One of you.
There's a method. Oh, my gosh. God, that could be either one of us, too. I'm going to say it was me, though. I think it was me. I think I said this. Oh, damn. Okay.
So it was on episode 85, The Man with the Wood, The Night for the Schwood.
Oh, my. Davis.
Episode 85. 85.
Holy crap. Yeah,
all
that
right,
was a while ago.
Mine is, who said the BBC needs to stop playing Star Trek? For like 2 months now. Oh my God. I'm done. I love it. But God, please stop.
That sounds like a Richard Gunther to me.
Final answer?
Boot him.
yeah, I'm going to say that's the final answer. Amos says it was him.
It was Stacey Baldwin.
Oh, okay.
Stacey Baldwin was on talking about her love for
Doctor Who.
I was about to say Doctor Who.
You were about to say Mr. Who. This is before he got his doctorate, when he was Mr. Who.
So she said the BBC needs to stop playing Star Trek for 2 months now. right. So Krunchy, go ahead.
Okay, I like this one a lot, and I'm just being nice to you guys. I'll do once again, this is either you or Amos,
okay.
But the quote is, holy shit, I'm so tired of the flaming vaginas and the bent dicks. Can we all just grow up and put our big girl pants on?
That's Amos, for sure.
It is.
For sure, that's absolutely something Amos would say. Oh, man.
All right, so I'm going to... Oh, God, there's so many good ones I don't want to pass over. all right, so who said, you're going to have to figure this shit out, boys?
Oh, God.
I'll give you a hint. It was a female guest.
Okay.
A female guest you've had on. She said... You're going to have to figure this shit out, boys.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, so the fact that she used a swear word eliminates a couple of our female guests in the past.
Not me.
Yeah, not the two of you, obviously. Oh, my gosh. God. Who would that have been? It might have been one of the two of you. We already used Stacy, so it's not Stacy. I'm going to say it was Krunchy. Damn it.
It was Tay Allen.
Okay. Yeah, okay. I can hear her saying that.
Yeah, by the way, I want to point out that Jopemon got it correct.
Yeah. The thing you have to know about me is I don't really use the pronoun boys because I have that weird pedophile complex thing going on. So.
I see. Yeah, actually, you probably would have said like gentleman or something like that, ironically. Yeah. You would have ironically said gentleman.
Yeah,
Krunchy, your go real quick. I think we've only got like two or three more.
Okay.
All right.
This one is one of my favorites because it's so accurate. It's insane. That's your hint.
Okay.
The quote is, "It's safe to assume that if there's a microphone in front of me and dead air that needs to be filled, I will continually talk into the microphone until told otherwise."
Okay, that could be someone in present company, but I think it was Roberto Villegas.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, he just said it could be you, Jackie.
I know. He's an asshole. You guys are such assholes when it comes to me. All right, just for that, I'm going to give you a difficult one. Okay, the difficult one, because this could be somebody from chat. Okay. Is who said, if South Park taught us anything, pig and elephant DNA don't mix? And that person is in chat right now. You can take hints from that person in chat.
I'm going to say,
if South Park taught us anything, I think your girlfriend already got it.
I think it was Fitz. No.
If
I'm changing
South
my answer.
Park taught us anything, pig and elephant DNA don't mix.
I'm going to change my answer to Joe Bong.
Amos. It was repeated by Amos.
Oh, okay. Okay.
The only reason it counts.
Okay. So I guess it would be Joe Bond.
Yeah. All right. All right. Is it Krunchy? You got another one? We got a few other good ones. Do we do two more? Two more? And we're done? You wrap it up?
Sure. Sounds great. Who said, it was so gross. So gross. It really broke my mind for a while.
Oh, my gosh. It was so gross. It really broke my mind for a while.
Sorry. Really kind of broke my mind for a while.
Really kind of broke my mind for a while. I'm trying to think who speaks that way. Because not everyone would word something in that exact way. So it really kind of broke my mind for a while. Oh, my gosh. You know, we've had 125 episodes, and most of those have had guests. This is really...
But none of these have been before, like, episode 90?
Well, okay. I tried to go way back, but it was hard because all of your podcasts on iTunes are only go back to 77.
Okay. That's still a long time ago. Oh, my
gosh. But I went back before... I went further.
So I'm trying, kind of broke my mind for a while. I don't think it was me or Amos that said that. I'm pretty sure that was a guest.
Yes, special guest. We'll add that.
I think Badweave might have gotten it.
Special guest. Okay. I'm going to say Brian Brushwood. I'm going to say Brian Brushwood.
You're half right.
Bonnie Brushwood. Oh yeah. My gosh, what was that in reference to? Did you write that down too, or because that's interesting. I'm trying to remember what she might have brought up.
No, it was like one of those pre-show things that you guys put together.
Gotcha. Watched the Bonnie episode. How did that start out? It started out with something about worms in the ass or something, right?
Yeah. And she was trying to back away from it. They're like, I want something that's so gross. And then you're like, all right, let's just start the show.
That's amazing. Holy
all right,
crap.
So the last, so we'll give you a hint. The last two are special guests. Or special,
very
fancy pants.
Oh, so like Jackie Hearn and Krunchy.
We totally skipped mine. I'm not funny at all.
You robbed me. I guess my go. Okay, who said we riot as a nation?
We riot as a nation? Oh my gosh, we riot as a nation. That kind of sounds like something Jury would say. That sounds like a Justin Young quote. I got it right.
Yeah, this. You got
amazing.
Write. Okay, Krunchy, you pick any of the rest.
Well,
get a good one. No. Okay.
I'm gonna go with, you know, there's only really like one we haven't done, even though we've been going out of order. There's really only one.
Well, you skipped.
Well, and the one I said, but that one's
okay,
not.
Okay, then we're gonna.
I don't think I'm funny.
God damn it, you just broke it.
Sorry. So who said, this is entirely too specific for my comfort level?
Oh my gosh, I remember that being said too, and I can't remember who said that.
And it's a he, and it sounds very much like the way they talk all the time, I think.
Okay, say it one more time.
If you were Krunchy, yeah.
Oh, shut up. This is entirely too specific for my comfort level.
This is entirely too specific for my comfort level. That almost sounds like something I would say. Entirely too specific for my comfort level. Man, that could have been a Richard Gunther as well. Crap.
Ooh.
You know what? Final answer. I'm going to say Richard Gunther.
Brian Brushwood.
That was a Brian quote.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So that's just kind of like a teaser. We've got one final one here, or actually a couple of bonus questions. But okay, here's the next one. You're going to have. No, wait, no, that's the wrong one. You're going to be known as Seizure Boy forever. Just quickly.
Seizure Boy.
You're going to be known as Seizure Boy forever.
That sounds like a Fitz. I'm going to say Fitz.
It's Krunchy episode 105.
Oh my God. Okay. Oh, actually, I do remember the story about Seizure Boy. Yes. That was a coworker story,
you know,
I think.
What? Not to be that guy that brings a showdown. But my coworker's family has only been getting so much worse, and I feel so bad for him. I work with him again now, and I'm glad. And he's not going to be moving now because of all this family shit.
Oh,
but his
man.
Mom just had a heart attack. The hospital was doing surgery, and they punctured her aorta, which is like the main like artery that brings blood to everywhere in your body. And it's usually fatal because of that and all the internal bleeding. But they fixed it by putting two stents in it. His grandmother, somebody was staying at her house taking care of her, and she tripped over their dog and fell down the stairs, and now she's a paraplegic.
Holy crap.
I feel so bad for him.
Damn.
I'm laughing.
Yeah.
I don't mean to laugh.
Well, all the good karma and prayers and happy thoughts and whatever, bubblies and rainbows and flowers and whatever else, send it his way.
Hot dogs,
yes. Send all the hot dogs to Seizure Boy. Like, holy shit.
I have one last question. The first Ritual Misery podcast to record live was A, Beta 1, B, Beta 2, C, Beta 5, or D, Beta 8.
Oh, geez. Okay.
Beta 1, Beta 2, Beta 5, or Beta 8?
I think it was 5. I'm going to say 5.
Shit, I love the answer.
I told you that's why I wasn't doing that one.
That's great.
I love the answer. No, I think it was Beta 5. It was Beta 5.
Yeah, okay.
It was Beta 5.
So, Jotmon points out that you can go to, dctvpedia. You can go to dctvpedia, and there is a Ritual Misery article.
Excellent, Jotmon.
Yes, thank you, Jotmon, so much for that. That is amazing. But you can see the breakdown of all of our episodes, who's been on the show, all kinds of cool stuff. Lots of amazing, amazing effort and work went into that. So thank you so much, Jotmon.
Excellent.
Jackie, Krunchy, thank you so much for putting that game together. Like, man, I can't wait to do another version of this when we have Amos on, and we could be against each other, do a head-to-head. That's going to be so much fun. I look forward to that. In the meantime, Jackie, you do puppet shows and do all kinds of cool stuff on the internet. If people want to find out more about that and see the things that you do, where would they go to do that?
They can find me on youtube.com/JackieHearn, and in a couple of days we will have a Opti puppet that will nag you about bunning pancakes or bacon. So you can get patreon.com/JackieHearn is what you won't want to. But yeah,
nope. YouTube. Everybody go check that out. Seriously.
No. YouTube.com/JackieHearn.
Awesome. And Krunchy, is there anything you got going on that you want to have people follow you on?
No. Everything I have going on right now is very for myself. So I'm kind of taking a break from social media. You can find me on Twitter at Krunchy89. Krunchy is spelled with a K. And I do have the blog, crunchfiles.weebly.com. I don't know how much that's really going to be updated either, to be honest, but it is there. And if I decide that something crazy happens, like I hope by the end of this hiatus, I end up like 30 pounds lighter. I don't know that that'll happen. But if it does, you'll know from crunchfiles.weebly.com.
Awesome. So. Everybody go check that out. That's really cool. That's basically going to do it for the show. I said earlier that if anybody wants to send us suggestions or ideas for anything, whether it's the TED Talk or anything else for that matter, you can email the show. It's podcast@ritualmisery.com. Everything that we've got going on is at ritualmisery.com. We're on iTunes. We're on Stitcher. We're on all of the places. And I encourage everyone to like, review, and subscribe in all of those places. If you're interested in following what I'm doing, I am at @RM_DelNoche on Twitter. I'm Del Noche everywhere else, to include Untapped if you're a beer person. Go check me out there. This has been your Ritual Misery Podcast. Thank you, everyone.
There is a goddamn music.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.